Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to another video of x86 assembly. In this video, we'll convert C program to its assembly equivalent and we will see changes in registers, modification of stack and etc. So let's get started. This is my C program. You can download this program using a GitHub account. I'll give the link in the description box below. I have created a new project C2 assembly 3 and I have set the project properties as I have described earlier in the setting project properties video. I'll give the link of that video in the I button above. First, we are including stdios.file. After that, we are going to the main. Main is calling function 1. We are in function 1. Then function 1 is calling function 2. We are in function 2. Function 2 is calling function 3. We are in function 3. Then function 3 is returning with the 3s. After that, we are in function 2. Function 2 returning with the 2s. Function 2 returning to function 1, function 1 returning with the 1s, and we are in main function and main function returns with the 8s. This is the same C program using an animation format for a better understanding. This is a C program. First we are including stdios.file. After that we are going to the main. Main is calling function 1. We are in function 1. Function 1 is calling function 2. We are in function 2. Then function 1, 2 is calling function 3. After that we are in function 3. Then function 3 returning with the 8 threes. After that, function 3 is ending here. We are back to the function 2. Function 2 returning with the 2s. Function 2 ending here. After that, we are in function 1. Function 1 returning with the 1s. Function 1 is ending here. After that, we are in main. Main is returning with the 8s. Main ends here. Now we'll convert this program into the assembly. For that, first click on build. Build solution. Okay, build is succeeded. Now we will set a breakpoint here. After that we'll click on debug. After debugging we'll right click here and we'll click on go to disassembly. This is our C program and its assembly equivalent. So I have divided the program into different functions for a clearer understanding. First we'll start with the main. This is our main. This is function 1. After that, this is a function 2 and this is a function 3. Let's look at the program flowchart. Main calls function 1. Function 1 calls function 2. Then function 2 calls function 3. Function 3 is returning to the function 2. Function 2 returning to function 1. And function 1 is returning to main. So that's it for this video. From the next video, we'll see how this program works. Thank you.